Get ready to match the stars. Bob Barker, Red Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Arlene Francis, Richard Dawson, and Fatty Pryor. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene River.
That's right. I match the carpet on the floor. If I lay down, you wouldn't even know I'm in the room. How are you?
Dinner, the sizzler?
It's a little rusty, isn't it? Thank you very much. Any other suit jokes or color jokes, get them out of your system now, because we got some business to attend to here.
Right. I think you look smart as
paint. Thank you, my dear. Let's say hello to Carol Bardos and Henry Bivacqua. Carol is our current champion. As you well know, if you've been tuned in for lo these many days, she has won a total of $20,250. And she's being challenged by Henry Bivacqua here. This charming fellow did very well here, didn't he? With his first round question, didn't he?
Yes, yes.
He did. That's fine. Yes, there for him. Yes,
great.
So we got to work that out for you, haven't you? Well, we'll see where this game goes right after we see about this message for you.
Oh,
hey. All right, here we go. Listen, yesterday when we started this game, we were very close to the end, so we didn't get a chance to find out the life story of Henry Bivacqua. So let us all listen to that right now. Henry, tell us where you're from and all that.
I'm from Miami, Florida.
Yep.
Birmingham, Alabama. What are you yaying for?
It's close.
Okay. I've got three kids and the second most beautiful granddaughter in the world.
Aww. Who's the first most beautiful granddaughter?
Everyone else's grandchild.
Oh, I see. Okay. Is that all you want to tell us?
I'm a former springboard diving champion, pro and amateur.
No kidding.
Yeah.
You devil.
Yeah.
Son of a gun.
Well, what were you champion of, Henry?
New York State, Florida State.
You were United New York States State Navy. Champ and
yes.
Florida State champ?
That's right.
And what was your specialty, the high board or the...
No, 10-foot spring
10-foot board. And what kind of dives did you take?
Oh, you name them.
Really?
How about swan?
Swan, that's easy. Anybody can do that.
Yeah.
The jackknife?
All right, it's so easy. Do a swan dive right here on this stage.
Gene?
What?
Brett, you know, she's been in many dives.
She has.
And she's been with me.
All right, here we go. We are going to finish round one now. Carol, this is all yours.
They got mixed up back there.
You were flashing the lights unnecessarily. Everybody plays in this round. Just do what I tell you to and stop flashing the lights.
I'm easily confused.
I know. The apartment manager said to Frank, "You'd better be quieter in your kitchen. Last night, you woke everybody up when you tried to shove your blank into the garbage disposal."
Is that Frank Sinatra?
No.
Are you sure?
Frank, you better be quieter in your kitchen. Last night you woke everybody up when you tried to shove your blank into the garbage disposal.
It could be Frank Sinatra. There's no last name.
No. Apartment manager said to Frank, "Well, maybe, I don't know.
Could it be
Frank Sell? Frank, who's he?
Sell. Frank.
He's a dear friend,
oh, friend of
ours.
No
Hi,
plugs,
Frank.
Please.
Oh, excuse me.
All right. Everybody ready?
Wait.
Then why are we waiting around here? Carol. The apartment manager said to Frank, "You better be a little more quiet in your kitchen. Last night you woke everybody up when you tried to shove your blank into the garbage disposer."
Wife.
The little lady said wife. What do you say to that?
The little lady said wife, and Bob Barker said wife.
That's true.
And the lovely, talented, brilliant, intelligent, scholastic, darling, adorable, pretty, lovely, and Fanny Flagg's friend also said what?
That's two for Carol. Charles?
Wife is a good answer, but a beer can would make more noise.
Right.
It would.
Yes, indeed. A beer can would be very noisy. Of course, a beer can can't scream. What do you say?
I say I'm embarrassed.
Why? You got a rotten answer?
absolutely rotten.
Well, let me just see how rotten it is. Wait a minute, let me just preview it there.
Compared to beer can, it's not bad at all.
Oh, it's bigger than a beer can.
It is bigger than a beer can. It's bigger than a bread box. Show them.
Stove. I'm
so
ashamed.
That'd make a lot of noise now, wouldn't it?
I've got no friends.
Not if his wife were Harriet Beecher Stowe.
Oh. Harriet Beecher Stowe.
Yeah, I'm trying to get you out of
yes,
here.
Yes, there's no way to save
don't
that.
Don't suddenly become a critic.
No, yes, no, I'm crazy about
it. Yeah, last night you woke everybody up when you tried to shove your blanket into the garbage disposer, and she said wife.
I say, take my wife, please.
Okay, that's
two for you.
That's two for her. What about you?
Well, I say I'm very upset thinking about a husband trying to dispose of his wife because I think the Institute of Marriage is wonderful. I've often said that I would give up my career for marriage.
Cut!
Often. wife.
Wife. Okay. Time to go to round two. All right, Henry.
A.
A it is. One person plays. It's you, my dear.
Oh, I feel so alone.
Yeah, no, I'll hang around.
Let's kiss a lot and forget the show.
Okay. I have a bicentennial question for you.
Yes, sir.
200 years ago today.
Yes.
George Washington married Martha.
Right.
Martha discovers that not only are George Washington's teeth made of wood,
but
but, I say, you are all ahead of me. Wait for Uncle Gene to finish the sentence.
Yes, sir.
But his blank is made of wood, too. Oh. And that's the way it was 200 years ago today. And remember, you were there.
I want to be the only one to answer that question.
You gotta be the only one. Because he's got five, and you're the only one that didn't match him in the first round.
And Jean, just to think, she used to work for a profit-making organization.
That's right.
Does anybody want to help me?
Not. You're on your own.
I am alone.
You're going to Canada.
Would you read that question again?
She'll have to go to Canada in the morning.
200 years ago today.
His teeth were made of wood.
Not only are George Washington's teeth made of wood, but his blank is made of wood, too.
Good luck.
The lady has written an answer.
That I'm ashamed of, even for George Washington.
Put it in the slot and
pardon
shut
me
up.
Again? Oh.
Okay, Henry. You want me to do the whole thing?
No.
No. Oh. What kind of talk is that, Henry?
You tell him, Henry.
Henry, join me.
Not only are George Washington's teeth made of wood, but his blank is made of wood, too. What do you say?
Head.
Head. Head? You say head? All together now, wait a minute. Ooh. Cut. All right. What are you doing?
Henry, come with me. I have a little something for you.
Come over here, Henry. Come here, Henry. Wait a minute. Henry. Now hold everything. Do you remember what these mean people did to Henry when
awful.
He said hit?
Awful.
All
you're
together.
Awful.
All together.
Boo! Boo. For shame.
You didn't know the audience. Boo that audience. Party! All right. Now listen, we've got to do your question. You're going to have to match two just to achieve a tie. We'll see what happens right after we do this bit of business, whatever it is. Pay attention. Ready. Here it is, Carol.
Okay.
Listen carefully now. You need two to tie. That's
who plays?
Well, who's Arlene writing? Plays Carol. And Charles. Charles
I
and
don't play.
Arlene. So I shall stand between you so that both of you
Arlene
will
works
be able to hear.
Alone.
Private Jones was court-martialed when they caught him blanking in the colonel's foxhole. Private Jones was court-martialed when they caught him blanking in the colonel's foxhole. Private Jones was court-martialed when they caught him blanking in the colonel's foxhole.
Who's doing it with me?
Charles.
I don't know, but Charles.
Wonderful Charles.
I was trying to figure out what he was writing there, but I couldn't read upside down in that case. All right, Carol Bartles. Private Jones was court-martialed when they caught him blanking in the colonel's foxhole.
Wedding.
Wedding. That's W-E-T-T-I-N-G.
Right.
Wetting. All right, Charles. Got to match both of them now, Carol, remember? And if you don't, it's the end of the line.
You forgot something. She has that magic piece of blue paper there.
She does. Indeed, she does.
So naturally, she will get making a non-military wet.
Amen. Score is now 6-5. Arlene, it's all up to you.
I am more refined than he is.
Oh, really?
Nobody I wouldn't say it. Wet.
What would
I
you say?
I said tinkling.
Tinkling! High score! So, now with a tie score, what we have to do is start all over again. We'll just erase all of this stuff here and push this button and come to one tie-breaking question for each of you. The one who scores the most will be the winner. Henry, may we have your selection?
A.
A it is. Here we go. Tiebreaker. When Elsie the cow got married, she didn't throw a bouquet. She threw the blank. When Elsie the cow got married, she didn't throw a bouquet. She threw the blank.
Honey, I have got the answer for this. Because I used to live in the
country. Lucky charm she carried. What is that lucky charm she carries?
It's a little piece of paper.
She should start marketing those. You know that?
That's right.
After that's coming through
a terrific talisman, isn't it?
It is indeed.
All right. Let me see now. This light is not on. And all right.
Come along.
Ready now? Here we go. Henry, when Elsie the cow got married, she didn't throw a bouquet. She threw the blank.
Bull.
The bull. Henry is very alert and came up with a splendid answer, Bob.
Henry's answer is splendid, and I'm sorry I didn't match him. I said milk stew.
Oh!
In a history of bad answers, that's the worst you've given.
That's the worst. Where did you see her?
You mean her?
I was going to say cow flap, but a lot of people don't know what that means. All us country kids know, don't we?
Yes, of course.
But I said the bull.
The bull!
One for Henry.
Charles? Did Elsie throw the bull?
I said a stupid, boring answer. I said she threw the pail.
Oh, another dummy! Now, Arlene, we come to you. She didn't throw a bouquet. She threw the bull, according to Henry.
I don't know how she threw this, as a matter of fact, but it just occurred to me suddenly that she threw the udder.
No. Go to your room.
You can't throw those, right?
No, you can't. They're attached. Okay. And it would sting something fierce. Richard?
I think you can turn them, can't you? Isn't it a biblical saying?
Turn the udder cheek. Turn the udder. Bull! That's two for Henry. Fanny?
I say Farmer John's hands are freezing. Bucket.
Bucket. So that's two for you, Henry. Now, Carol, two to tie, three to win. That's the way it is. At the Royal Bank. Oh, you don't want to do this now. You want to do a commercial? You want to do a commercial. He wants to do a commercial, but he doesn't. Let's see. Are you ready? Okay, here's a commercial. Where have you been? Now, we are in the second half of the tiebreaker here. Henry scored two with his. That means you need two to tie, three to win. At the Royal Banquet, the king said, I don't think the roast pig was cooked long enough. It's blanking. At the royal banquet, the king said, I don't think the roast pig was cooked long enough. It's blanking. That's the first thing to do is pick up the pen. Okay, good. And then you put it right in the slot there. Salute. All right, everybody.
Wait a minute.
You changing your mind or just a little addendum there?
Wait a minute, darling.
Oh. Come on, Brad.
Well, I am, honey. Now, don't cry. I'll just burst into tears. I'm so tuckered out as it is.
All right, Carol. At the royal banquet, the king said, I don't think the roast pig was cooked long enough. It's blanking.
Oinking?
Oinking. You hear that pig oinking on the spit?
I heard that, and I have no place to go but up after
yes.
a milk stool, right?
Right? Okay.
Will you buy oinky?
Oinky!
I'm so proud.
One more oink and you get a tie. Brett?
Nah.
Okay, Bob Barker gets to tear up my answer. I said it's giving birth.
That's the worst. <to tear. laughs>
I don't know what come over me.
Yeah. Charles?
I said breathing.
Breathing. Would you tear his up too, Bob?
That's the second word.
Yes, it's a terrible. Now we come to Arlene. She's looking for an oinking pig, Arlene.
I think an oinking pig is winking.
A winking pig. So far, can't get another oink out of this bunch, Carol. Richard, you give this girl an oink.
Well, another word for oink with a pig is squealing. That's oink.
Really? Well, that's news to me, but that's what it is. Okay. Fanny, it's up to you.
Oink, squeal.
Squeal! Henry, it was a pleasure meeting you.
A lot of fun.
You're a splendid fellow, Henry Bevacqua. We've got some gifts for you together with our thanks for being here in Match Game 75. Bye. Goodbye. Now, Carol Bartos, there it is. We must stop meeting like this. We polled a recent studio audience, Carol. We got their best response to this. Blank market.
Got
I remember
it.
The top answer is worth $500, $250, and $100. Whom do you call it?
Brett,
what
about
do you say?
Supermarket?
Supermarket is what?
Richard?
Farmer's Market.
Farmer's Market, right next door to CBS here.
And Fanny.
Black Market.
Black Market. So you got those three, Black Market, Farmer's Market, and Supermarket. Do you want one of those?
Super.
Super is the one she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and it's so well. We will now reveal, for all to see, the $100 response. Farmer's Market is the one that Richard gave you. Looking for supermarket, let's take a look at the $250 response. Stock market. Very good answer. I didn't even think of that one. Last chance for supermarket. Here's the $500 response. Supermarket. Okay. Now, you're going to play not exactly for 10 times 5, but since CBS has a limitation of $25,000 to any one player, you will be playing for $4,150, which will give you an even $25,000. But to collect, you got to match one of them head-to-head.
Brett,
get ready to write. Here we
go.
No,
I get so nervous.
With the $4,150 and 47-cent question there. Blank Matt, M-A-T. Blank Matt. M-A-T. Just put it in the slot when you finish and do it quickly.
Oh, talk about flop sweat.
All right. For $4,150, now, Carol, how do you fill in that blank mat?
Doormat.
All right, Brett, let's see it. She says doormat will match you.
Oh, boy, am I mad. I said bath mat. I was
bath
sure
mat.
It was going to be bath.
All said bath.
You all said bath mat. She said bath mat. Welcome, Matt. Okay.
We all said bath.
All right, Carol, you're up to $20,850, and you're still the champ. But now, let's take a look at this message. Well, there's been a lot of excitement here with our new all-time high money winner of over $20,000.
Did I win that much?
No, you didn't.
Oh.
That sweet little Carol, Carol, whatever her name is, who's been here
you
for 3 months.
You think you'd know it by now.
Listen, next time we get together, some of these people will come back and some will not. But
why
these
not?
Are the ones who will be here.
Sheldon Leonard, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Louisa Moritz, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg.
Gene Rayburn, join us next time. Match game 75. Goodbye.
For Tattletales, next over most of these CBS stations.